Professor V. Geethalakshmi has been appointed as the Vice-Chancellor of Tamil Nadu Agricultural University by Governor R. N. Ravi. With over 26 years of teaching experience, her initiatives had led the university to sign 11 memoranda of understanding with national and international institutions. Hello, I'm Shikha Yadav. You're watching Agribusiness News. Let's start with the latest updates. PepsiCo India has collaborated with Drip, the manufacturer of an innovative gravity-powered micro-irrigation system to help farmers in India adopt game-changing technology in water efficiency. The technology has already been introduced in the states of Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, and Rajasthan to improve water efficiency levels across thousands of hectares in the country by 2025. Country Delight, one of the leading dairy brands, has secured $65 million in its Series D round from new and existing investors, including Trifecta Capital, Venturi Partners, IIFL, and Elevation Capital. The company had earlier raised $25 million in its Series C round in November 2020. Brands of CNH Industrial, New Holland Agriculture, Case IH Agriculture, and Steer Tractorin won 4 gold medals at the 27th International Fair of Agricultural Techniques Agrotech 2022 in Poland. The brands were awarded 4 gold medals for the New Holland Combined CF7.70 crossover harvesting, New Holland T7 heavy duty agricultural tractor with PLM intelligence, Case IH Optum 300 AF Pest Connect tractor, and Steer Absolute 6240 CVT tractor. Nestle is working directly with farmers to cut emissions and enlisting its suppliers to find ways the company can invest in hard infrastructure efforts to reduce their footprint. Nestle plans to inject $1.3 billion in regeneration production practices over the next 5 years to cut emissions by half before the end of the decade and become net zero by 2050. 1 year after its initial announcement, BASF has reaffirmed its ambitious climate targets. In an update for investors and financial analytics on its transformation roadmap, BASF confirmed that by 2030, it aims to reduce its greenhouse gas emissions by 25% compared with 2018 and in maintaining its goal of net zero emissions globally by 2050. Lulu Group will be investing ₹3,500 crores to set up shopping malls, hypermarkets and food processing and logistics centers in Tamil Nadu. The MOU has been signed in the presence of Chief Minister M.K. Stalin and Lulu Group Chairman M.A. Yusuf Ali. Ingen Technologies, a fully owned subsidiary of Worms, has launched SecuLock, a smart e-lock for life monitoring and prevention of theft and pilferage in milk tankers. The pre-installed device can capture and transmit location data to a central server for an en-route theft and pilferage prevention. Deere & Company has entered into a joint venture with SurePoint Ag Systems and its subsidiary SurePoint Electronics, a leader in plant fertilizer and spraying mixing systems based in Atwood. The joint venture will operate under the brand names SurePoint Ag Systems and SurePoint Electronics. Union Minister for Fisheries, Animal Husbandry, Parshottam Rupala, while inaugurating the National Business Meet on promoting exports of value-added meat products organized by APEDA in New Delhi, called upon stakeholders to create region-specific animal disease-free zones in the country to boost exports of value-added meat products. Indigo Agriculture, a company leveraging nature and technology to unlock economic and environmental progress in agriculture, announced the appointment of John Frederick as its Chief Financial Officer. Agri Expo 2022 has been organized by the Directorate of Extension Education, Shri Karan Narendra Agriculture University, from 28 to 30 March 2022 in Jubner, Jaipur, Rajasthan, with the theme Towards Smart Agriculture. Krishi Jagran's team is also present at the expo. For more such agri updates, keep watching Krishi Jagran Business. Thank you.